Right, like I said, it's gonna set my soul, gonna set my soul on fire. Got a whole lot of money that's ready to burn, so get those stakes up higher. There's a thousand pretty women waiting out there. They're all living the devil may care, and I am just a devil with love to spare. So Viva Las Vegas, Viva Las Vegas. How I wish that there were more than the 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't sleep a minute away. Oh, there's blackjack and poker and the roulette wheel, a fortune won and lost on every deal. All you need is a strong heart and a nerve of steel.
Hi, and welcome to another edition of the Jungle News. I'm Janie Kopitz.
And I'm Logan Cole.
The 2018 Winter Olympics started on February 9th and ended on the 25th. The games were held at Pyeongchang, South Korea. 92 countries competed for the top spot in the medal count, but Norway took first this year. The women's hockey team and the men's curling team both received gold this year, aiding the United States to a fourth place finish in the medal count.
In addition to new clubs, there's a new sport starting up.
Here's Reagan with the new sport of men's volleyball.
There has been a local initiative to begin a men's volleyball team for all West Florida Salem High School boys. This is due to the growing trend of high schools across the state considering growing their athletic program like the local schools at Graham and Greenan are. These interested students had their first open gym Saturday, February 17th in the auxiliary gym. There are currently 113 schools across the state of Ohio that have a high school men's volleyball program. Sophomore Cordell Wiley, who has no prior experience in organized volleyball, was really surprised with the repetition and level of difficulty that volleyball requires. But overall, he believes that the first open gym was a success.
I thought it was pretty good. I was shocked, I guess, by the amount of guys that actually went out to try. I didn't think many people would. I thought me and Elias were two of the only guys that would be interested in it, so it was kind of a shocker.
In Ohio, there are 8 divisions for high school men's volleyball that range from having 6 to 20 teams. Senior Elias Kripper-Naprakowski believes that regardless of his injury at the first open gym, it was a good starting place for the possible formation of a men's volleyball team at West Liberty Salem.
Just like seeing what people could do after literally their first practice they've ever had and first training that they've ever had. Just the ability to actually get up and hit the ball down in any way, shape, or form was impressive.
The sport's preseason begins February 26th through the state tournament that is held June 2nd and 3rd. Senior Bailey Schaefer believes that he was hands down the most valuable player of the team and that the intense once-a-week practices will lead to complete domination, not just from him, but the entire team.
Not only are we going to have a team, but we're going to win every single match we go into. Like, we're going to walk in there and our swagger alone is going to scare the other team.
Do you ever find yourself thinking, been there, dug that, about all the spring activities? Then maybe you should give men's volleyball a try. This has been Reagan Horman. Reporting for Jungle News.
Are you tired of those pesky stains?
Hi, Millie Bazier, and I have the product for you. It's the Mean Green Cleaning Fist.
It cleans your walls, it cleans your shirts, and it even cleans your friends.
I love the Mean Green Cleaning Fist.
Order the Mean Green Cleaning Fist now at 1-800-GET-FIST.
On February 14th, a gunman opened fire in Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. The shooting left 17 dead and several injured. The cause of the shooter's actions is unknown. This led to be the 18th school shooting this year, which resulted in high school students demanding more gun control laws.
Spanish Club is back. The club started on February 27th and celebrated by having a party. They will continue eating tacos on the last Tuesday of every month. Only students currently in Spanish class can be part of the club and will be hosted in Senorita Link's room. Savannah Weaver and Aaliyah Spirit started this backup due to their love of the foreign culture.
Logan, have you heard about the new outbreak of senioritis?
Yeah, I heard it affects 99% of high school seniors.
Here's Alex Smith with the story.
As the West Liberty Salem school year heads into the second semester, the graduating seniors are showing a decline in motivation. The seniors are failing to turn in assignments, not paying attention in class, and coming in late to school. This lack of motivation and eagerness to graduate is characterized by the term senioritis. Addie Wilson, who's missed 26 days of school, strongly agrees senioritis is plaguing WLS students.
100%. Hands down, I feel like over half the grade has it. Even people like Reagan Horman and Allie Smith, who used to work hard constantly, like even they're just slacking this year.
In a recent poll, 46 out of 47 West Liberty Salem seniors said they believe senioritis is a real condition. And likewise, 46 out of 47 seniors believe they are suffering from senioritis. Mr. McGill thinks there's only one way to overcome this devastating condition.
So it just depends on that person's individual attitude, I believe. That's the key to victory over senioritis.
Symptoms of senioritis include laziness, skipping class, napping in the guidance office, and a flat-out disinterest in school. If you are suffering from any of these, get help. The only prescription is graduation. Nick Williams feels he is suffering from many of these symptoms.
I wait till the day before to write my papers. It's kind of a stretch for a senior paper, but I got it in.
As you can see, senioritis is plaguing the classrooms of West Liberty Salem High School. Watch out, or you'll be next. This is Allison Smith reporting for the Jungle News.
Key Club held a student-hosted dance from 7 to 9 p.m. for all faculty and parents of middle and high school students on Saturday, February 17, 2018. It was held in a WLS cafeteria to raise money for Key Club and to give the parents and staff a night out. A couple dozen individuals showed up and included a live rock band performance. Key Club members held various jobs throughout the night, such as babysitting, cleanup slash setup crew, and even chaperoning.
The flu epidemic this year in the United States is at an all-time high, killing approximately 4,000 Americans per week. The alleged culprit for this 2018 flu epidemic is the lack of flu shots in America. The percentage of effectiveness this year is 36%, an all-time low in a decade.
So have you joined any new clubs this year?
Yeah, I joined the American Doll Dress-Up Club.
Oh yeah, don't they have that every Friday morning in Mr. Linksweiler's room at 6 a.m.?
Mm-hmm. Here's Tori with more details.
Every year, there are official clubs that WLS students can be a part of. But this year, there is a new unofficial club added to the list. Book Club joins Cout Club in the debate of whether or not these qualify as official clubs. Both of these clubs were started by the teachers involved. Mr. Lewis believes that Cout Club is a very important club to have at West Liberty Salem.
It's the food, but it's also the fact that we're celebrating and we're enjoying that those kids are working hard. And we're out there doing calc to keep America safe.
Calc Club has been a club since the 2015 school year. The students participating in Calc Club claim that they have to do very difficult math problems to get a reward. Once a month, the club meets to solve these math problems and get to eat food during each meeting. Elias believes the best part of Calc Club is not the math problems.
The food is awesome and worth it. And, you know, it's just something we get to hang out with friends and eat food. It's not like lunch at all. Not at all.
The junior class has added book club to the school year to discuss what they are reading. Mrs. Arnold felt that giving the students the chance to openly discuss about the books would be beneficial for her class. The club has read two books so far, but according to Addie Johnson, there is a social aspect of the meetings along with discussions.
We just meet during homeroom sometimes every couple weeks and talk about the book or just eat and hang out.
Whether the clubs are official or not, students are getting the chance to hang out with their friends and get the opportunity to know their teachers better. This has been Tori Cordell reporting for the Jungle News.
On February 17th, the Lions Club hosted a pancake breakfast at the Liberty Gathering Place to raise money. The money will be used for West Liberty Salem School District projects. Around 200 people are estimated to have attended, and about $400 was raised.
An armed robbery took place at the Bell Fountain, Tim Hortons, on February 26th after closing hours. No one was injured, but the thief fled on foot with $280 from the cash register.
He was allegedly wearing a red coat and black pants. Janie, have you gotten your prom dress this year?
Yeah, I got it a couple weeks ago.
Cool. I got mine at the prom dress resale.
Oh. Here's Cookie Kavua with the story.
The West Liberty Salem sophomore class and Miss Haney hosted a prom dress resale on February 24th in the high school cafeteria from 1 to 4 in the afternoon. They wanted to provide affordable prom dresses for girls. The sophomore class sold the dresses on consignment for a $5 fee. They came up with the idea from Mrs. Arnold, whose daughter that went to Minster High School did the exact same thing, and they believed it was a great way to sell cheap, beautiful dresses. Morgan Fissel is very excited to start this new tradition.
I think it'll go okay. There's a lot of interest with people coming in to look, but we haven't had a ton of interest in people bringing dresses to sell. So that might be a bit of an issue, but I'm sure it'll work itself out.
The experience included a fitting room, a runaway, and a bake sale. Girls were welcomed in, and not only could they look at the dresses, but also try on a dress they liked. There was also a makeup set featuring Mary Kate that was setting the models' makeup and advertising their beauty products. Miss Haney, the sophomore's advisor, was excited to combine her prom advisor experience with this new experience.
We did pretty well considering we did have a little bit of a poor turnout, but I am very excited to try again next year, and I think after doing it once, it'll just keep building over and over and over again.
The models were Taylor Hanel, Alex Burton, and Rachel McGill. After getting ready, they walked the runway to show off their dresses. Senior Taylor Hanel was glad she had the opportunity to do it with Alex and Rachel, and overall glad she was a part of this experience.
I thought it was a lot of fun. We got to do a little runway show, and it was just kind of fun to put on a dress and makeup.
Even though the prom dress resale didn't turn out as expected, Miss Haney and the sophomore class are expecting a good turnout in the following years to come. This has been Cookie Kabua reporting for the Jungle News.
Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Jungle News.
I'm Miss Fortune.
And I'm Miss Hat. Now, who are our gold card winners? Wrong video. Here's Tori with the
We're good. You guys meet every
Friday
at 6 a.m. in Mr. Link's Wilder's room.
Meet every frick.
In addition, meh.
I feel bad for the key columbers. I have to babysit all those siblings.
I gotta wipe the sweat off my face.
You can't even tell.
Okay.
You're doing great.
Alright, are we good still? Okay.
Here's Reagan with the story of men's volleyball.
I said it wrong. It's okay. All right.
Oh my gosh.
It's so hot. Okay. Hang on, I gotta sneeze. Okay, I'm good.